Hey you chaps, and welcome back to another episode in my series of This War of Mine tutorials. Today's episode will focus on the basics of combat, mainly weapons and characters, but I'll be releasing two more episodes in the coming weeks on more advanced mechanics and fighting tactics. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss them. So, without further ado, let's get started. First things first, we need to think about which people we should send out to fight. Every character can throw a punch, but some are better at it than others. To keep it simple, I have split all the characters into five grades, with D as the lowest grade and A a star at the top. Let's quickly go through the grades. Top of the class, we have Roman as our only A star character. This guy can literally murder enemies with his bare hands, I'm not making it up. He also has the second most health at 4, second only to the A grade character Boris, who has 5. All other characters have 3. This includes both of the other A graded characters, Erica and the custom police officer character. By the way, I made a tutorial ready on making custom characters. You can check it out if you want. Just saying. This video will be back here when you come back. Anyway, these characters can hold their own in a fight, and coupled with their impressive traits, they can sometimes even be more useful than Roman. Next, we have the B grade. Quite a crowded group, really. These guys can hit the target, but I wouldn't send them out to fight anyone who is trained in combat in any way, shape or form. These people are Bruno, Amelia, Marin, Marco, Pavle, and any custom psychologists, pharmacists, and foresters you can. Again, the fact that these characters sometimes have useful traits means they can trump higher grade characters. Now, we're getting quite low here. Grade C. These are the characters that, if they tried to throw a punch, it may probably land on their foot. These are the people who are a lot safer left at home, in bed, with all the pointy objects kept out of reach. I would suggest never, I repeat never, fighting with these people, as they will most likely lose. These people are Anton, Katja, Zlata, and the custom computer specialist. The only one of them who is ever worth sending out is Katja, for her bargainer trait. But be sure she's polite whilst out. You don't want her in a fight she can't actually win. But if you think those four people are bad, then the D-graders are absolutely horrific. Zlata and the custom insurance agent wouldn't know what end of a shotgun the bullet came from, and a rocking chair would probably dodge most of their hatchet strikes. Never, I repeat never, send out these guys to fight. They will lose, there is no question about that. Oh, I suppose that's a bit harsh, I'm sorry Zlata. Maybe your trait makes up for that. Well, moving on! So, those are the final grades for all the characters. Be sure to pick the right one for each fight, or risk an awkward conversation and a really large drop in morale. But, what is a fighter without their weapon? A boxer? A wrestler? No, but mandatory ironic dated meme aside, they're dead. You're going to lose if you don't have a weapon. You need to arm them. So let's have a look at the weapons available to you. Every character can have two weapons equipped at any one time. One ranged and one melee. For this reason, I'll split all the weapons into two groups, aptly named ranged and melee. Melee weapons are used to beat your opponents into submission, and can range from your own clenched fist to a lightsaber. Unfortunately, this war of mine has no lightsabers, and so you have to settle for the next best thing, an axe, or hatchet, as it is known as in the game. Joking aside, any grade of character gains a significant boost from a hatchet, and even grade C characters have been known to kill unprotected opponents in one hit with it. The rest of the melee weapons, however, line up in this order. Second most powerful is the knife, followed by the shovel, and then the crowbar. And finally you have fists, which is only really a feasible choice for the A-star graded Roman. However, it is worth remembering that hatchets, shovels, and crowbars can all break eventually, and so make sure you grab a spare or have a spare knife on backup, just in case you get turned into mincemeat by the guy that you just hit and is now extremely angry with you. Anyway, you can avoid these close encounters, however, if you start to use these ranged weapons, or guns, as I think the kids say, I believe. Anyway, these come in a wide variety of shapes and sizes, namely, four. They come in four shapes and sizes. Let's start right at the bottom, with a gun whose name is really taking the piss, dull. Pistol? Get it? Get it? I'm sorry, anyway. But seriously, the pistol is the easiest gun to get, but is also the weakest by far and has the shortest range. So I would suggest it, not for massive fights, but maybe for taking out one guy, that's the most. If you want to take out more than one guy, next up is the shotgun, which is insanely powerful. if you are standing 3 foot from them. If you're standing any further away, you might as well spit at them with the amount of damage you're going to do. The close proximity you have to use for the shotgun kind of renders the whole range thing pointless, but the damage really makes up for it. And if you couple that with a decent melee weapon, you can pretty much take anyone out in a couple of seconds. It's quite powerful. However, if you'd much prefer to stay further away from your opponent, you have the assault rifle, which is next. And it does a decent damage from any real distance, but eventually it does peter out once you get too far away. But the only problem is, literally every other soldier has one too. Meaning that if you can hit them, they can hit you. So it's kind of a level playing field. There is one way, however, you are going to get the advantage in this fight. And that is, you can stick a scope on the top. And that somehow makes your bullets go farther. I mean, it actually does. A tube stuck to the top of your weapon dramatically increases your range. Go figure. This is the scoped assault rifle, which is what I'm talking about, and it can only be attained from the snipers at the constructor site. It's literally a unique weapon. Anyway, both the assault rifle and the shotgun are good weapon choices, and so choose the right one for you. Shotgun for up close and personal, and the rifle for distant and reserved. And the scoped assault rifle, I suppose, for even more distant and even more reserved. Anyway, now we know who you'll be fighting with, and what they'll be fighting with, you should probably be looking at the people you're going to be killing. Similarly to the playable characters, we are going to grade all the enemy characters on their physical prowess, with 4 as the most inept, and 1 as the most physically able. However, there's over 60 possible characters, I'm going to generalise. But they do all fit into a category that I will mention. Let's start with 1, as everybody does, with the guys who really should know how to fight, the military. These guys will literally kill a lot of characters with one shot and then get on with their lives as if nothing ever happened. In all honesty, if you do come up against one of these guys, make sure it's with Roman wielding an axe, like Gimli in Fellowship of the Ring. Otherwise, they will definitely not kill them without taking a few hits yourself, even with Erica, Boris or PC Plot. These A-grade characters, however, do get an even match when faced with level 2 opponents. These opponents are the armed thugs and guards that you encounter at most other settlements. These guys hit hard. Very, very hard. If you want to take them down, I would suggest you send Roman or a heavily armed grade A character to avoid injury, or a grade B character maybe if you don't mind a couple of scratches. However, I would likely save grade B characters for the next level, which is level 3, the common man or woman. This level includes all unarmed civilians you may counter, once you get past the initial guards and the thugs, obviously. They can land punches, and they are quite deadly in large swarms, but when they are on their own, they are quite weak. My suggestion is to split them up and try to take them out one by one, but if this isn't possible, sending Roman with a hatchet should be good enough, especially if he has any armour on. Finally, this last group, well, grade 4 or level 4, I suppose. Well, these people give Savetta a run for her money in physical ineptitude. They are the elderly and the ill. And while Savetta could probably take them out, I probably wouldn't risk it, and I would send probably a C grade or higher to actually get the job done. Next, though, we will be looking into how to fight and the best ways to deal with large groups of enemies. But that will have to wait until next time. The next episode should be out in about a week's time, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. Also, if you want to see these fighting skills put into action, I kinda have another series called Bloodlust, where I go around trying to kill every other character in Pokemon. Thanks so much for watching, and please comment below if I missed anything. Thank you guys so much for watching again, and I'll see you guys next week. Ta-ra!